Oath of office, please raise your hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
Junar Abol Iranti Chan.
And your address.
Pahok Lapu-Lapu City.
Having been elected to the position of
City Mayor.
Hereby solemnly swear that I will faithfully discharge to the best of my ability the duties of my present position and of all others that I may hereafter hold Under the Republic of the Philippines. That I will bear true faith. And allegiance to the same. That I will obey the laws. Legal orders.
And decrees.
Promulgated. By the duly constituted authorities. Of the Republic of the Philippines. And that I impose this obligation. Upon myself voluntarily. Without mental reservation. For purpose of evasion.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
I am but a humble public servant whose dedicated is time, energy, and resources to make a difference in the community and improve the lives of others. The extensive experience I gained through the years in public service has taught me the valuable lessons that could serve as my tools in tackling the city Crofton. As one-time city councillor of Lapu-Lapu City, I was able to deliver what was expected of me as a legislator, despite being the local opposition in the council. With no committee chairmanship, as the barangay chairman of PAHO, I was able to bail the barangay from bankruptcy and generate the needed funds to support the various free services that we have introduced to the PAHO annals. Now that I am the mayor, I will ensure that every single Okunganon gets to avail of these free services that we have initiated. I will replicate all these programs in a larger scale for a city-wide implementation. True to my campaign promise of prioritizing health among others, I will expand the free medical and dental checkup that we have started in PAHO. We will conduct regular free medical dental missions and give free medicines in all 30 barangays, including those in the islands. We will bring health services closer to the people. Atong ipatuol ang servisyo ngadto sa katawhan. Libreng konsultasyon, og labaw sa tanan, libreng tambal alang sa mga tubig natong mga cognizance of our limitations. I will join the private sector to help me realize this endeavor. As part of your corporate social responsibility, I encourage every establishment, resort, and hotels operators to adopt a barangay where you can do a periodic free medical and dental mission. We will cooperate with the Department of Health, the various medical organizations, as well private medical practitioners towards meeting this end. Perhaps we can enlist the health and expertise of our very own, a proud Okunganon, Dr. Wyman Rios. For illnesses that need confinement, sadly, our Lapu-Lapu City Hospital is one sick institution. Hindi siya ika ang dampanan sa mga masakiton na himong dalang kining transfer station. Kailagi, kulang man ang himanan sa pagpanambat. Kinahanglan atong talungon kung atong ayuhon ang atong hospital aron matuman o pagpahanan. Something is amiss on how the facility is being run and managed. I ask Dr. Dela Rosa to investigate and leave no stone unturned. We will rid organization from corrupt individuals who have unabatedly defrauded the city's healthcare delivery system to enrich themselves. Surely, heads withdraw. I will likewise ask him to come up with recommendations on how we can improve operations of Lapu-Lapu City Hospital and upgrade its category to a level 1 hospital capable of surgery. We will also have experts to help us design a healthcare delivery system that is both preventive and curative. Likewise, we will make the Santa Rosa Community Hospital fully operational by upgrading its facilities and augment staffing complement para ang mga masakiton sa isla di kinakilanglan mudabang pa sa dagat aron magkakamba. Laging nalibre mao ang livelihood training na atong isugdan sa paro o karon atong palaptan diri sa atong labayan. We will build a TESDA accredited training center to provide free livelihood trainings that are responsive to the demands of our city industries. And in fact, we will be supplying our industries with a pool of skilled workers that would meet their respective demands. I therefore appeal to the owner of our establishments, businesses, and mass makers to prioritize our Okumanos training graduates in hiring for more. Apart from the free livelihood training, our administration will lobby for conversion of the Lapu-Lapu City College into a state college in order to make college education free and accessible. As I said, free and accessible for the Okumanos. This is another free among many. Under our administration, aron magkaan ng patas na oportunidad ang mga estudyante sa isla magpupod kita ng public college sa Olanggo. Usap ni sa atong mga saan panahon sa kampanya o atong palipanutan na matagaan ni ang kakumanan. To assist our students in their research projects, we will open an e-library where students can avail of free computer use, complete internet connection, and free printing. This is another successful project that has been tried and tested in Barangay Power. Our administration will also give priority to the housing needs of our informal settlers. Atong ipatuman ang socialized housing program sa atong isa. Gani, una na ipipila ang mga investor kami palayag sa ilang kaandam o takana sa pagtukod po niya sa mga housing units. After the fire that hit CQ Paradise of Paho, which left hundreds homeless, I saw the needs for our informal centers, especially those living in a danger zone, to be relocated to a much safer and decent resettlement site. I am positive that with the help of Secretary Avelino Sigol, Secretary Michael Dino, we can fast-track the implementation of socialized housing in Canpulao that has been stalled for many years. Atong usap ang kalugan na matagan ng basic services sa atong mga kaisulan, ilabi na ang tuas isa. We will ensure a 20 24/7 power supply in Olango. We will request currently uninterrupted water supply in the entire city of Lapu-Lapu. Also, top among my campaign promises is to build a new public market. I will instruct my market liaison to look for a valuable location where the new public market will soon rise. I will likewise order the city engineer to look into the structural integrity of the newly renovated old public market and have the observation validated by independent experts to ensure that building is safe for occupancy. Ato tarungon pag-apur-apur ang mga stalls sa merkado aron ang tanan matakaan kung patas na kayunan sa pagpaminabuhi. As regard to the city worsening traffic woes, I will give marching orders to the traffic police and the city MS to strictly implement traffic laws and spare no one. There will be no sacred cows in this administration. Apprehend to those operating without franchise and terminate from service personnel found guilty of wotong. There is no room for such shenanigans in my administration. A short-term solution, I will ask experts to review the city roping scheme to decongest our streets and make the flow of traffic more fluid. Long-term solution would be the construction of flyovers as well as the widening and opening of new roads. It may seem ambitious, but I believe that completing the equation in solving the city traffic problem is to build skyways along major thoroughfares for the adoption of a mass transport system and the opening of coastal highway traversing through Barangay Baba, Kalawisan, Tanghulaw, Lupo, Poblacion, Aho, Usok, Ibo, Buaya, and Mactan. On the issue on garbage, I empower everyone to do a citizen arrest on anybody found to have obviously and willfully littered the surrounding. To make it cooperative, I will give incentives to those who can apprehend violators. The no segregation, no collection policy will be strictly implemented. Likewise, I will lead a regular coastal clean-up drive and award the barangays who actively and consistently pursue this endeavor. Keeping our city clean will also help us attract more tourists and investors. Being a major tourism hub and the gateway of the South, we will reap the city with eyesores and give tourists a welcoming vibe to jumpstart their vacation experience. We enjoy the hotel and resort operators, most of whom are present today, to extend our visitors the best service available and make sure is to put a smile on their faces at the end of their stay. Also, aim to keep the tourists coming and investors to pour in capital the airbase of the Philippine Air Force, the Central Command, the Naval Base Station, all in the same island. There is no safer place than Lapu-Lapu City. Apart from keeping them safe, it is best that we give them a friendly feel to entice capitalists to invest more. It is my administration's trust to transform Lapu-Lapu City into a friendly city. In order to achieve this goal, we will reap our government agencies with fixers and should do government construction the right way and without shortcuts. We will do away with practices that breed corruption and implement instead the ease of doing business up. I encourage those who will encounter crooks in their dealing with City Hall to report directly to me, and I will assure you they will be terminated not a minute longer. No more red tape under my administration. We will make processing of business permit easy for you. We will expand all possible assistance for your businesses to flourish and generate job opportunities for the Okananos. I will make myself available always. You may ever call me anytime, and I'll be glad to take your calls. I will be a hands-on city manager, and I will be managing the city affairs 24/7. Ours will be an inclusive and participatory governance that will balance the interests of the city and that of our constituents. We will make sure that he who has this design will not be left behind. Election is over. Let us sit aside politics and let the healing process begin. Let us join hands and together we work towards effecting the change we want for Lapu-Lapu City. Let change start from each one of us. As Mahatma Gandhi puts it, be the change you wish to see in the world. I personally appeal to the honorable members of the City Council, regardless of political affiliation, to rally behind me, and together we row in one direction for the common good of the Okananos. I also appeal to the men and women in the different departments of the City Hall to put public interest above personal partisan interest. Let us work and make our salary worth every centavo of the taxpayers' money. As I formally end my speech, allow me to express my sincerest gratitude, first and foremost, to the Almighty, to our patron, the Ren Saregla, and Señor Santuni, for the wisdom and protection. My most profound thanks to Secretary Adelino Aristotle, and to Secretary Michael Lloyd Lino for bridging me to the President. Dagdag salamat for trusting me to lead his presidential endorsement. Walay lituman ang akong dagdagong pasalamat kaninyo, Secretary Mayor Adelino Adisidor, ang atong amahan at isdanan. Pagkato ni Secretary Michael Dor Quino. To the team Ahong, team Libre, daghang salamat sa inyong pagkuhan ng alako. Dili dali ang atong nasinati. Buwan o init, atong isuong araw lang maabot nato ang mensahe sa kausapan. To Attorney Eugene Espirito, thank you for the principled insight. To my state Vice Mayor Elect Celci Sidon, re-elected Councillor Nelson Yap, and Councillor-elect John Vincent de la Serna. And to those who did not make it, I want to share this honor with you. Please rise as I call your names. June Alforno, Kino Kahim, Attorney Susan Mari, Yuzi Hayashi, Joy Polares, Attorney Ferdy Juno, Kim Francisco, Dr. Emilio Galarosa, Esco Hinik, Montfort Tagoy Jr., and to our campaign managers, Boots Parami and Jimmy De La Serna. Maraming salamat sa ating mga masipang papa. And also to our all CTU leaders, barangay mayors, barangay congressmen, family leaders, ang ato ang pastor for change, ang ato mga parallel, the 30 parallelist group, and all the supporters na itabang sa kampanya. Daghang salamat for the waiting sa battle team. Magpuban niya akong kaninyo sa pagservisyo sa katawang pupungano. To the members of the business sector who casted their doubt on me, thank you. I appeal for your continued and unwavering support as we chart a new direction for Lapu-Lapu City. I am confident that through a strengthened public-private partnership, we will be able to deliver the goods and services despite the impending budgetary constraints. To my family, for all the unconditional love and support, thank you so much. Salamat.